हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई विल होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई एम भूपेंद्र वर्मा, योर साइंस टीचर। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर थर्ड ऑफ क्लास सेवेंथ साइंस। इन दिस सेक्शन वी डिस्कस अबाउट सिंबल्स, एलिमेंट्स एंड देयर प्रॉपर्टीज। फर्स्ट इज व्हाट आर द सिंबल्स। सो वी नो दैट नाउ डेज टोटल 118 एलिमेंट्स वर डिस्कवर्ड एंड वी वर्स यूज द सिंबल टू रिप्रेजेंट द एलिमेंट्स and the compound by their formula. So first of all, the scientist who used the picture symbol to represent the element, that is alchemist represent the picture symbol, but picture symbol is not so famous in nowadays, so we use the modern symbols that is given by the Berzelius. We use the modern symbols of elements that is given by Berzelius, and the modern symbols are most important to revise these formulas. Okay students, I hope you understand and remember these formulas. Some elements are represented by using first letters, that is a capital name. For example, carbon is an element, its symbol comes from its first letter, that is C, and first letter should be capital. For example sodium, sodium symbol comes from its Latin name natrium, and symbol is Na. First letter should be capital and second letter should be small. So here we observe the examples: carbon symbol is C, nitrogen symbol is N, oxygen symbol is O, and that some elements have the same initial letter. For example, carbon, calcium and cobalt are comes from their initial names, and first letter should be capital and second be small, but the some symbols are come from their Latin names, like copper symbol is Cu, it's come from its Latin name cuprum, and similarly the Latin name of potassium is kalium, and symbol come from its Latin name kalium. And sodium, Latin name of sodium is natrium, and its symbol come from its Latin name Na. So these are the some methods to find the formulas, elements and their symbols. Let us discuss about formula. Before discussing about formula, we watch some table elements. First is aluminum, symbol is Al, come from first two letters. Calcium, Ca, come from first two letters. Carbon, first letter. Chlorine, first and third letter. Copper, come from its Latin name cuprum. And gold, come from its Latin name aurum, Au. Helium, symbol is He, come from first two letters. Hydrogen, symbol H, come from its first letter. And some more here, iron come from its Latin name ferrum, Fe. Nitrogen come from its Latin name come from first letter N. Oxygen from first letter O. Potassium comes from its Latin name K, and kalium and symbol is K. And similarly, sodium come from its Latin name natrium, first two letters Na. Sulfur, S, and tungsten come from its Latin name wolfram, and zinc, Zn. So these are the some elements and their symbols are given in book. So we need to revise these symbols and their element name, because these symbols and elements are helpful to us to understand formula of the substance. So we know that the molecule of the water contains atoms of hydrogen and atom of oxygen. So the formula of the water should therefore contain the symbols of hydrogen and oxygen. So what do you understand from the formula? Formula of substance tell us what are the constituent of the compound. That means the compound is made up of which kind of atom, and tells the name and gives the information about the element that are composed in compound. For example, NaCl, sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is made up of sodium atom and chlorine atom. So one sodium atom and one chlorine atom is used to form the sodium chloride. And it can also tell us, formula of the compound also tells us how many atoms present in a given compound. For example, H2O. So two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen is present here. Total atoms are three. This is known as atomicity. The total number of atoms present in a given compound or a molecule is known as atomicity of it. One more example for it: glucose, C6H12O6. So how many total atoms? 6 atoms of carbon, 12 atoms of hydrogen and 6 atoms of oxygen. So we get total 24 atoms. So atomicity of glucose is 24. So this is a given by the formula of compound. I hope students you understand up to here. Next is formula of compound. So we first learn formula of compound of hydrochloric acid is HCl, iron sulfide is FeS, magnesium chloride is MgCl2, sodium oxide is Na2O, magnesium oxide is MgO, carbon dioxide CO2, methane CH4, and the atomicity. Here helium atomicity 1 is found in H form, hydrogen found in H2 form, its atomicity is 2, and similarly under overall given. So we need to read them and learn them. So how to form these formulas, we learn with the help of method known as cross valency method. So before knowing about these formulas, we discuss some chemical species and their structure. For example, valency of sodium is +1 and chlorine valency is -1, then we cross the valency of those, then we get the formula NaCl sodium chloride. And some more formulas are also I have provided in a notes video to you. So do the practice from those formulas from the notes. Next is atomicity. I hope students you all have to clear better what is atomicity. The combining tendency, atomicity is a number of atoms present in a molecule or compound is known as atomicity. Number of atoms present in a given compound or a molecule is known as atomicity. So I hope student you are able to find atomicity of the given compound. You know that what information given by the formula of compound. So formula of compound tell us how many atoms are present in it and their other physical ratios. Now writing the formula, how to write the formula. So first of all we learn these valencies. What is the valency of hydrogen? 1, sodium valency is 1, potassium 1, copper 1 and 2, mercury 1 and 2, chlorine 1, fluoride 1, nitrate 1, calcium 1, 2, iron 2 and 3. And use these valencies, we prepare the formula that is known as cross method formula. First we need to use formation of hydrogen chloride H and Cl. What is the valency of hydrogen here? 1, chlorine valency -1 because hydrogen has plus valency here. Then we get it HCl hydrogen and chloride. Hydrogen chloride is the name of the compound. So in this similar manner we prepare the chemical formula and I have provided the lots of practice to you, so do the practice from there. The last part of the chapter is chemical equations. So chemical equation is basically that the chemical changes which we have studied in last class. What are chemical changes? The changes in which new substance is formed from old one substance is known as chemical change. These chemical change in chemistry is known as chemical reactions, known as chemical reaction, like shoring of milk, ripening of fruit, rusting of iron. These are the some example of chemical reactions. Now we need to represent these chemical reaction in an equation form is known as chemical equation. If we represent these chemical reaction in equation form, then it is known as chemical equation. So here are the two parts of chemical equation, reactants and products. What are the reactants? The substance which are represented on left hand side before the arrow is known as reactant, and after the arrow the represent are known as product. That means the substance initially that are used is known as reactant and they are formed as known as product. I have shown in notes here. You understand from here what is reactant and product. Chemical reaction, it is a process in which a new substance is formed. First of all, what is a chemical reaction? It is a process in which a new substance is formed from old one substance is called chemical reaction. That means a kind of chemical change. For example, rusting of iron, shoring of milk. What are the reactants? The substance which take part in a chemical reaction are called reactants. So chemical reaction mein participant hote hain. And they represent in equation on left hand side. What are the products? The new substance which are formed during a chemical reactions are called products. They represent on right hand side. And what is chemical equation? The method of representation of chemical reaction in form of proper chemical symbols is known as chemical equations. So these are the some definition that tell us what is a chemical reaction and chemical equation. For example, when the nitrogen react with hydrogen to form ammonia gas. So nitrogen and hydrogen here are the work of a reactant. They work as a reactant, and ammonia is formed after the arrow is used on the present on right hand side is known as product. I hope students you understand well what are the reactants and what are the products. Now the lots of examples given here, the reactions, and next step and last step of the chapter is balancing of chemical equation. So what is the mean of balancing? Balancing means the total number of atoms on a reactant side is equal to total number of atoms product side. We need to balance then equal the number of the atoms on the left hand side and right hand side, and we say before the reaction the number of the atoms and after the reaction are same. So first example here, the nitrogen atom is 2, hydrogen atom is 2, and on right hand side before balancing nitrogen atom is 1, hydrogen atom is 3. So we need to equivalent them. So how to multiply with them? Here's nitrogen 1, here's nitrogen 2, hydrogen 3. So multiply this with the 2, then nitrogen becomes 2, then one part is equal, then hydrogen 3 to the 6. Now we multiply the hydrogen with the 3, then 3 to the 6. So hydrogen on the both sides is equal now. This is known as balancing. Let us discuss next example. Sodium and water react to form sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. Now we need to balance. First of all, we check the atom. Sodium is 1, hydrogen is 2, oxygen is 1. Sodium, hydrogen, oxygen. On right hand side, sodium is 1, oxygen is 1, but hydrogen is 3. So we need to balance them. So first of all, we multiply this equation with the 2, then odd number becomes an even here. So hydrogen becomes twice, and 2 and 2, 4. So multiply with this 2, then oxygen becomes twice, hydrogen twice here. So oxygen is twice also. Then multiply the sodium with the 2, then it is balanced. I hope students you understand well. That's okay. This chapter is completed now. Thank you and have a nice day.